you never seen a white person before. Jaws all on the floor, they panic, Tommy just burst in the door. Started whooping her ass worse than before. They first were divorced, sewing her over furniture. It's the return of the... Oh, wait, no, wait, you're kidding. He didn't just say what I think he did he? And Dr. Dre said...
First time I had grabbed the mic, I got booed before I even said anything. You know what I'm saying? And then as I started to say this, the boos just got louder and louder and louder till I just got off the mic. And I was like, damn. I started growing up a little bit and I just got better, you know? I mean, when I was like 16, 15, I was whack. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know how I wanted to sound. I didn't know, you know, barely anything. But... You know, 18, 19, I started, like, learning, like, all right, this is how I should sound on the mic, and this is how I need to do this. You know what I'm saying? And learning how to battle and just, you know, practicing freestyle.
Hi! My name is...
What?
My name is...
Huh?
My name is...
The first time I ever, like, got any type of respect was the first time I had grabbed the mic in a hip-hop shop. And I had said some ish, and it was kind of like people was quiet at first, and then I heard a couple of... cheers, applause, and then applause, and then applause, you know what I'm saying? And it got louder and louder. Some songs take longer than others to write. It just depends on, I guess it depends on what type of mood I'm in or what I'm thinking at that time. I just collect ideas and I write little ideas down just anywhere on a sheet of paper, just like scattered ideas and little words and just little metaphors or whatever, anything. And... then just start piecing it together whenever I feel like it's time.
The looniest, zaniest, spontaneous, sporadic, impulsive thinker, impulsive drinker, addict, half animal, half man, dumping your dead body inside a f***ing trash can with more holes than an Afghan.
My shit is like therapy for me, not only when I'm writing it, but when I'm in the booth saying it, you know. It's kind of like, it's a way for me to get this shit off my chest.
So when you see me on your block for two blocks, screaming all the world like two pops, just don't give up. Talking to this be on my back, dirty Mac, and telling your boys that I'm a out. Just don't give up. So put my tape back on the rack.
I make my music for me, and I know how I want it to sound. I don't really think about, like, is everyone else going to like this? I listen to it, and I make it for me so that I'm satisfied with it. Because I feel like if I am satisfied with it, then everybody else is going to like it. You know what I'm saying? So I might find, if I say the word the wrong, I might go back and change it. You know what I'm saying? Like, usually when I write my songs, the formula for me writing my songs is pretty simple. I write the verses and then just sum up all the verses with a hook. You know what I'm saying? And just sum it up. But my delivery and the way I say things across the mic, I make sure that is just, like, perfect. You know what I'm saying? I want to make sure everything is perfect for me so I can listen to my ish a million times and not find a flaw in it.
It's not worth the risk, not over this list. Drop the biscuit. Don't even listen to Slim, yo. He's bad for you.
You know what, Dre? I don't like your attitude.
Dre basically saved my life. You know, my ish was going nowhere. And Dre kind of took me in. I couldn't afford to buy diapers. You know, I didn't have a job. I had, like... job after job after job and just kept getting fired, you know what I'm saying? And I didn't have a high school education, I didn't have a diploma, I failed ninth grade 3 times, as the world knows now, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I was basically going nowhere, and I felt like when I made the Slim Shady EP, I told the production people that I was working with, FBT, I told them, I was like, yo, if this doesn't work, you know what I'm saying? I'm about to be 23 years old, I gotta get out, I gotta do something. You know what I'm saying? I gotta leave. I gotta quit. I gotta quit. I gotta get a job. I gotta do something. You know what I'm saying? And then we just so happened to go to LA like that same year, you know, and Dre heard the tape and Dre gave us a call. So Dre has taught me a lot. Not just rap wise, but business wise, you know what I'm saying? So it's like whatever I can do to return the favor, you know, I'm here. You know what I'm saying? So it's kind of like we just work together and we just got a chemistry that works, you know? And for however long it works, I'm gonna make it work.
What you say?
What's wrong? Didn't think I remember?
I'ma kill you, you little motherfucker.
Ah, temper, temper. Mr. Dre, Mr. NWA, Mr. AK, coming straight out of Compton, y'all better make way. I wonder how you gonna tell this man not to be...
My thing is this, if I'm sick enough to think it, or I'm wrong enough to think it, then I'm wrong enough to say it.
I'm like a head trick to listen to, cause I'm only giving you things you joke about with your friends inside your living room. The only difference is I got the
don't consider myself insane. I don't consider, you know what I'm saying? I don't walk around like, you know, like a fucking lunatic. You know, I consider myself day to day an average person, like, you know, pretty normal. You know, my thoughts, when I write thoughts up in my head, things that I think of, I think everybody else thinks a lot of this shit I think of too. They just don't say it. And my thing is, I just say it. You know, when thoughts get in my head, I just write them down. I think I might think a little bit different than the average person. But like how I act and how I dress and how I carry myself, I feel it's, you know, it's normal, you know. I think the young people are getting it. And I think the older people are getting it confused. I think the older people are tending to take my dish too literal, you know. But I don't care. It's funny to me. You know what I'm saying? Because if I say my fucking brain fell out of my skull and they really believe it, you know what I'm saying? And what's wrong with them? You know, people, the younger people got senses of humor. You know what I'm saying? They got a sense of humor so they know to determine the right from wrong and shit like that. You know, people, I think kids are a lot smarter than we give them credit for. It's not rocket science here. It's so clear, you know, when I'm joking and when I'm serious, but some people just don't get it.
I guess it's a Slim Shady in all of us.